Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel MST Physics, where physics gets charged. The last video we discussed motion of the particle perpendicular to the direction of electric field. There we are finding the path of the projectile and the displacement equation and time taken by it to reach the positive or negative plate and some different cases. So now in this video, again the particle is perpendicular to the direction of electric field, then what is the velocity and the direction of the velocity after certain time we are going to find here. Okay, so in this now I am projecting the particle of positive one is with a velocity u. So as it experiences the force in the direction of electric field, so that it is not possible to move, so remains along the straight line. So we can take the path of this projectile like this. Okay, so and we are projecting initially in the horizontal direction only, so horizontal direction of velocity as u, and there is no velocity of the particle vertically downwards at the point of projection, so that the vertical component of initial velocity is zero. Okay, and now after certain time, if you want the velocity of the particle at any point, the tangential drawn is gives the velocity at that point. So when it is in a plane, this velocity will be resolving into two mutually perpendicular components. One is a vx and another is a vy here. And the important thing is there is no force on the particle along the horizontal direction. Why? Because here just we are considered the electric field only, and that electric field is vertically downwards, and we are not considered the effect of gravity. So there is no force along the horizontal direction on that projectile. When fx is zero, this implies ax is zero. When there is no acceleration of the particle along the horizontal direction, means horizontal component of velocity is a remains constant, which means we can write vx is equals to ux, that is equals to u, which is said to be constant. Means the problem is as it experiences the force in the vertical direction, that too because of the applied electric field, and that force can be written as a q into e. When it experiences the force in that direction, it will get accelerates with an acceleration q e by m. So now as the initial velocity of the projectile, initial velocity u bar is equals to, we can write a ui cap, and our intention is to find the final velocity. To write the final velocity, vx is remains constant, but vy is changes. At first I am finding the vertical component of velocity after certain time t. Vertical component of velocity after time t, after time t, so that for this I am using the equation vy is equals to uy plus ay into t, uy plus ay into t, so that here we can write vy is equals to uy. Initially there is no velocity along the vertical direction, so its value is zero, plus ay is a qe by m into t. So therefore we can write vy is equals to qe by m into t is the vertical component of velocity. When you have the vertical component of velocity of certain time, you can write a final velocity of charged particle, final velocity of charged particle. That final velocity you can write as v bar is equals to vxi cap plus vyj cap, right? So it is 2D. So v bar is equals to vx is u only, so it is along the horizontal direction, and vy as a, when we are assigning the coordinate system to this, as upward is a positive, downward is a negative, so we can write minus q e by m into t j cap is from here. This is the way we can write the final velocity. And if you want to write its magnitude, mod v bar is equals to under root of u square plus q e by m into t whole square under root. This is the way we will get the velocity and its magnitude after certain time t, after certain time t. Now if you want to find the vertical component of velocity, vertical component of velocity after certain displacement, after certain vertical displacement, okay nama, so that here we can write to find this, vy square minus uy square is equals to 2AYSY I am using here. So by using this here we can write a VY, we are going to find UY. Initially there is no vertical component of velocity, so it will become 0, is equals to 2AY, AY is a QE by M, SY is nothing but Y only. Therefore, by using this, we can write VY is equals to under root of 2QE into Y by M is the vertical component of velocity. And if you want to write the final velocity here, means V bar is equals to again Vx is the UI cap, and a vertical component of velocity is downward, so minus 2QEY by M J cap. So this is the final vertical component of final velocity, okay, after certain displacement, and this is what after certain time, depends on the question please, and again its magnitude mod V bar is equals to under root of U square plus 2QEY by M. This is a way we can write the magnitude of final velocity after certain time as well as after certain displacement. So now we are going to write the expression for direction of resultant velocity. So here to find the direction of final velocity here, so the angle made by that velocity with the horizontal is gives the direction is nothing but here alpha. So by this, to this alpha, if I am taking opposite by adjacent, so this tan alpha gives the direction of velocity. This direction of velocity we can write Vy by Vx. Opposite side is the vertical component, adjacent side is the horizontal component. And after certain time we got just now QE by M into T. So we will get a tan alpha is equals to QE by M into T, and horizontal component of velocity is remains constant. So it is a U only, or you may write a alpha is equals to tan inverse of QE by MU into T is the direction of the velocity after certain time. And if they are asking the direction of velocity after certain position, so again we can write tan alpha is equals to Vy by Vx, that Vy just we have here only 2QEY by M by Vx is U. So that here we can write tan alpha is equals to under root of 2QEY by MU square. This is a way we can write the direction of final velocity in terms of time as well as in terms of position or vertical displacement. Okay students, these are the very important for mains and NEET level. Thank you for watching. If you are like my videos, do like, share, comment and subscribe our channel to get more videos.